Hi guys, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well, hope you're having a great day, and as always, thanks to everybody that's subscribed. So I'm now going to be listening to a track by Frankie Goes to Hollywood, and it's called Two Tribes. I'm very familiar with this track, as I remember it from June 1984, and it was number one for a number of weeks, and the video was really, really interesting, and I think it involved President Reagan basically having a fight with is it Brezhnev or, well, the Russian president anyway, and it was called Two Tribes Go to War, so two people were fighting to see who won the war, I guess, and that was a gist of the video, but this is something a little bit different. I'm going to be reacting to an Annihilation mix, which I have been told is very different from the original song, but nonetheless, there's a chance that I may have heard this back in a distant day of 1984, somewhere on the radio. I used to play a lot of remixes and stuff, so this could be a revisit, but I'm not too sure yet. Like I said, I definitely know that I know the song, so yeah, without further ado, I'm really looking forward to this. This is 9 minutes long, so buckle up and join me on this journey.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me present Frankie Goes to Hollywood, possibly the most important thing this side of the world.
Oh, yeah. Well,
Beat.
Of the eternal court of history will smile and tear to tatters the brief of the state prosecutor and the sentence of this court, for she acquits us. Condemn me. Condemn me. Condemn me. History will absolve. Singing, this will be the day that I die.
Shelter, put them outside.
them outside, but remember to tag them first for identification purposes.
So, I mean, sorry to pause it there. Going back to the original, a lot of his stuff wasn't on the original. I haven't heard this. I have heard a different mix to this, but I've never heard this. Just the very beginning of his song, actually, with the air raid siren, is just so disturbing and a little bit scary. And this is quite a really, I'm finding this quite a dark, uncomfortable version. If your grandmother or any member of your family dies, put them outside. It's just, it's very matter of fact. And wow, yeah. And I have to say, the production on this, I think it might be Trevor Horn, who did this Annihilation mix. I'm only guessing, but production on this is fantastic. And it's very, very, it's got a really good kind of beat to it as well. But very disturbing. Just everything else is very uncomfortable.
Just think of it. War breaks out and nobody turns up.
Yeah, that'd be great, that would.
If any member of the family should die whilst in the shelter, put them outside, but remember to tag them first for identification purposes. If any member of the family should die whilst in the shelter from contamination, put them outside, but remember to tag them first for identification purposes. Or any other member of the family should die whilst in the shelter, put them outside. But remember to tag them first for identification purposes. If your grandmother or any other member of the family should die while... identification purposes.
It's enough to make you wonder sometimes if you're on the right planet.
Just got to say, actually, sorry to pause it there again, but over the first half of his song, Holly Johnson's vocalizations over the beat and in and around some of the narration bits, it's really kind of dystopian and, again, quite disturbing. It's almost like crying out. But it's, I think it sounds like it's about to go into the main part of the song.
When you hear the air attack warning, you and your family must take cover at once. Do not stay out of doors. If you are caught in the open, lie down. And now, here is a reminder about fallout warnings. When fallout is expected, you will hear three bangs in short succession, like this. In some areas, the warning may be given by means of three gongs, like this. Or you may hear three whistles. All these three types of sounds indicate that fallout is expected. Them, you must stay in the safest position in the house. Keep the door shut. Do not go outside the house until you are told it is safe. Here is the all clear one. When you hear this sound, you can leave your cover.
Two Chimes by Frankie Goes to Hollywood, and that was an incredible mix. I'm really sort of struggling to even say the word mix, because that just sounded like an incredible interpretation by the same band of their own song. It was really, really, really effective having the siren at the beginning. Having the first half of the song, it's almost like preparing you. Narration on that about getting ready getting ready for a nuclear attack, to find somewhere safe in your house. I mean, how realistic would that be? I mean, where would you find safe in the house in a nuclear war? Even in 1980, you would have probably been obliterated, or you probably would have died instantaneously from radiation poisoning. But yeah, it's really, really disturbing. And it's also, I was thinking throughout that song of, this was 1984. In 1980, we had the series Freds, which was, and I think we had another one as well, but essentially they were really a dark view of what could happen at any minute. And in 1984, we had quite a few songs. I think even Nana's 99 Luftballons was about nuclear explosions and stuff. Nick Kershaw's song was about nuclear war. I won't let the sun go down on you. It seemed like from 1980, then to 1984, it was always hanging over us like this horrible sword of Damocles or something, that at any minute the war could break out. And we were still in the Cold War at that point. I think when Gorbachev took over, the mood changed a little bit. And I haven't felt that fear since, if I'm honest. But in the early 80s, up to 84, it felt like a very dark, dark thing hanging over us. And for Frankie Goes to Hollywood to kind of bring this song out, I thought it was amazing, really, that showed just how pathetic war is, and that really, if two leaders want to go to war, they should get into a ring and slog it out themselves, and whoever wins has won the war. But it shouldn't include any people, especially, you know, it's always the little people that would probably lose their lives in these things. And I'm sort of digressing a little bit, but this song really, really was seriously dark. And thought-provoking, really. And there's a bit as well which I I'm just about, I'm going to look it up now, is a little, I think it was somebody who was playing the part of Reagan came out of this, and so I'm just going to quickly look that up. Well, okay, so towards the beginning of his song, I think it's the voice of President Reagan. It's not him, obviously, but he says, you may pronounce us guilty 100 times over, but the goddess of eternal court of history will smile and tell that and tear to tatters the verdicts of this court. And just from reading that, this is actually based on Adolf Hitler's speech after he was tried in 1924 for plotting to overthrow the government. So it's actually based on a real speech, which is really kind of, it's incredible to think that it's almost, if you're intending to enter into a war of mutual destruction, mutually assured destruction, then really you should stand trial. If courts ever existed, you should stand trial retrospectively, or even before you go into that war, because to enter into such a war is just mind-bogglingly stupid. So I'm just going to quickly dive into the lyrics. I think that's enough about the music. It's music was great. So lyrics: when two tribes go to war, a point is all that you can score. Score them all, score them all. When two tribes go to war, point is all that you can score. So that's literally it. You're not going to win anything, because everywhere is going to be devastated, or desolate and ruined. It's mutually assured destruction, so there's not going to be any land for you to conquer. And the only thing that you could score is like a minor point that you won. That's it. Cowboy number one, born again, man, poor man's son. On the air, America, I modelled shirts by Van Hoosen. So this is actually harking back to something Ronald Reagan did as an actor, I think, in his early days before he became president, and he did actually model advertise shirts for Van Hoos. I think that's how it's pronounced. When two tribes to go to war, switch off your shield, switch off and feel. I'm working on loving, yeah, giving you back the good times, ship it out. Working for the black gas. Yeah, I have no idea what that means. I think black gas might be something to do with Russia. Switch off your shield, switch off and feel. It may be they're saying there that if we could lower our defences and try and understand each other on a human level, we might stop being so aggressive and warlike towards each other. We've got two tribes, we've got the bomb, yeah. Sock it to me, biscuits, now. Biscuits, a nickname for President Reagan? We are living in a land where sex and horror are the new gods. I wonder if that's a reference to the early 80s, maybe, that, you know, we've got this nuclear war hanging over us, but all we're interested in is selling sex and horror. In the form of entertainment, I'm guessing. Some of the lyrics are a little bit confusing to me. So guys, I'm looking forward to hearing what you think about this song. How does it make you feel? Does this bring back some dark memories from the early 80s to 84, when nuclear war was a real threat and a real possibility? Is this song far removed from the original Two Tribes as it was in its radio edit? Does this version put a different slant on the original song? So yeah, I'm just looking for a bit of feedback on this song. So if you want to join me in the comments below, I'm really, really interested to read your comments and thoughts on this song now, and on this track, and on this remix, which was the Annihilation mix. Please join me in the comments below, and till next time, I hope you have a great day and a great week, and hopefully we won't be suffering any nuclear mishaps or adventures over the next few days. Take care of yourself. Speak to you soon.